You better watch out. You better not cry. Better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be on some cute little DIY stocking stuffers that don't look like homemade or ugly little things that people aren't gonna actually want. These are gonna be really, really cute ideas that you would actually be proud to be giving out in a stocking stuffer. So I'm really excited to share with you guys what I came up with. Before we get into the video, if you're new and you have not yet, I would love for you guys to click that subscribe button. I'll have a cute little button floating around somewhere in the screen. But then, of course, as always, you can just click the little subscribe button down below on one of these sides, this side maybe? I would love for you guys to subscribe and join the family. So if you want to see how I created these super cute little stocking stuffers, then just go ahead and keep on watching. So the first stocking stuffer we're starting out with is some handmade soap. You're just going to need a block of shea butter soap that is microwave meltable. And you'll need some essential oils. You can get whatever kind of scent you would like. And then I'm just going to be using some food coloring and glitter. So what I'm doing here is I'm just popping the entire block of this shea butter soap out of the container. And I'm just going to be cutting off a little wedge of this. You just cut as much as you need depending on how much soap you're wanting to make. I'm just gonna make a couple for the sake of this video, but I might end up making some more, so who knows. I just ended up cutting, I think, 8 of these tiny little blocks. So I stuck those in one bowl and then cut off the same amount and then stuck those in another bowl. So this one I'm going to be adding red to, and the other one I'm going to leave white. Since this is white soap, you're gonna need to use a lot of red food coloring, otherwise it's going to end up pink. So I'm just putting this in, and then I'm going to be microwaving each bowl at 30-second increments, and I did that for about a minute apiece. Then I decided to add some red glitter to this bowl. This is totally optional because it does kind of come off on your hands a little bit. So if it's decorative soap, it's totally cool. But if it's going to be soap that you use, you might not want to. Then I'm going to be adding a few drops of the Candy Cane Scented Essential Oils. And basically what I'm going to do is I got these little snowflake molds, and I just got this off of Amazon. It said for soap, cupcakes, pretty much anything you could use it for. I'm just going to be slowly pouring a spoonful of each color and alternating that into the mold. What this is going to do is kind of give me like a tie-dye candy striped effect. And then I took a little like kebab skewer, you can use a toothpick or whatever you have, and kind of swirled it around to make it look like a candy cane. Or you could just do it one plain color. But that is what these turned out like. So this next DIY is going to be some coasters, and I don't know who came up with this idea, but it's absolutely brilliant. All you're going to need is some bakeable clay, you're going to need an 18 karat gold leafing pin, and then something to cut out your coasters with. Just anything you like the size of. It can be a cookie cutter. I just use the top of a mason jar lid. So what you're going to do here is just break your clay up. I decided to do 4 coasters for one set, and I'm just going to be rolling each little color out into kind of a little worm shape, and then I'm going to be twisting these all together. So I'm just going to be taking all 3 colors and then just kind of swirling those around. Once you have that all twisted up, then you can go ahead and roll this into a ball, and I'm just going to be smushing all the colors together. This is going to give it a really cool marbled effect, and it looks like I'm about to break the table here. So I smushed it all together once into a ball, and then I decided I wanted it a little bit more marbled, so I rolled the entire thing back out into kind of a worm shape, and then kind of repeated the same process. I just twisted this all together, and then I rolled it back up into a ball, and then I'm going to roll it out. If you're like me and you don't have a rolling pin, you can get crafty. You could use a spray paint bottle, you could use a wine bottle, anything you want to do. So as you can see, it gives a really, really cool marbled effect. I'm just going to be using this mason jar lid and pressing down and then pulling back the clay from the sides, and you're going to be left with a perfect circle. Since I didn't use a cookie cutter, the edges just needed to be flattened out a tiny little bit. All I'm doing is just rolling this on the side of the table to kind of flatten it out and give it a better shape. So then once you've done this, you can put some parchment paper on a cookie sheet, and you're just going to line these up on the cookie sheet. Then you're going to follow the baking instructions for your specific clay. Each one is a little bit different, so just make sure you know what to do. Mine took about 15 minutes at 200 and something degrees, but it was a very quick DIY. It's something I loved about this. Now that the coasters are baked and cooled, you can take your 18 karat gold leafing pin and just draw a gold ring around the edge of the coaster. This just adds a little bit more pizzazz and makes it look fancier and not so much of like a homemade DIY project. It looks like something you might actually buy. So I did the gray ones, and then I also did some Christmas colors. So this next DIY is super, super easy. I'm just going to be repackaging some of my favorite salt scrubs. You could also make a salt scrub and put it in these cute little containers. I actually got these from the dollar section at Target. And what I'm doing right here is just making a funnel. If you have a funnel, totally pull that thing out and don't even bother with what I'm doing here. But if you don't have one, just fold a piece of paper in half and then kind of swirl it into this funnel shape and then just tape it shut. And this will make your life a whole lot easier when you're trying to put things into your little jars. He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows when you've been better. So what I love about this DIY is how cheap it is. Like I said, I got these little containers from the dollar section, and I'm just going to be using a salt scrub that I already had, and I'm just going to be breaking this up into multiple containers. So it's really a very cheap stocking stuffer idea, and it just makes it look like you put a whole lot more time and effort into it than just giving something that's already made. So I loved this one. It's the cherry bomb flavor, so it's all red and festive. And then the next thing I'm going to do is I got these really cute little stickers in the dollar section of Target as well, and I'm just putting these on to some cardstock, and that's just going to make it a little bit more sturdy so that it's like an actual tag that I can string onto the little jars. So I'm just cutting these out, and then I'm going to be poking a hole through them and attaching them onto my scrubs. The jars I used already had a little chalkboard sticker on the top of them, but if you're using a jar that doesn't have that, you can buy the chalkboard stickers very cheaply or just paint chalk paint onto the lid. So I'm just going to be using this bistro marker and writing the scent of the scrub on top. And then I don't have a hole punch, so I just jammed a pin through this and that worked. I got this little baker's twine in the dollar section of Target as well. If you can't tell, I pretty much am there all the time and buying tons of stuff, but look how cute and festive that is. So you just pull your little sticker around the front, write who it's to, and then if you're using a pre-made scrub, you can write on the back which one it is so that if they like it, they can go and get it themselves. Or if you made it yourself, you can just write made with love or something cute like that. So this was it for my DIYs. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful if you're looking for some cute little stocking stuffer ideas. And that is it. So yeah, I love you guys so much. Don't forget to click thumbs up on the video if you enjoyed it and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. Thought it was nothing, but I guess I didn't know that there was something going on with